Hi everyone, it's Sam here from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to talk about form versioning. And what this allows you to do is keep track of what changes were made to a form, who made the changes, and when were those changes made. So you can see a bit of a history of the activity that's occurred on that form. And all of this helps to automate the audit trail underlying each form record that you keep inside of Dashpivot. So we're going to look at how this works for both timeline style templates and for workflows. And we're going to start off by looking at what this looks like for timeline style templates. The sequencing is quite straightforward, actually. If we add a new form, we'll see the version of this form displayed in the top right of the screen in the header. So you can see it's form version 1. And if we fill this out, let's say with some information about the day's activities. Won't fill out the whole thing, but just add in some example content. And let's say that we've filled out, you know, quite a lot of the form. You know, we're happy with sort of this first version. We would click the save button up the top, and it would save that into Dashpivot as version 1. Now, if we reopen it and make some changes and save those changes, it's going to up-rev to version 2, and then version 3, and version 4, and so on. So I'll show you how that works. So let's reopen our form now, and make some changes. And you can actually see that the form version, it tells us that we will be saving this form now as version 2. So if we click save, we've now saved version 2 of the form. And so we can repeat this process, and it's just going to continue ticking up, you know, version 3, version 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And it'll just keep going. What I want to show you now is how you can actually see what those changes were, who made the changes, and sort of the log of actions that have occurred within this form. So if we click this button up the top that's next to the save button, it says show activity. It's actually going to show us a log of all the changes that have been made so far. So we can see who created the form and when it was created. We can just hover on this time here, and it tells us the date and time. And every subsequent edit that's made since then, whether it's you or anyone else who's modified this form, it will show their name and the timestamp of when it was modified. You can also click on these where it says edited V2, we can actually click on that and see what the changes were before and after. So we can see in the version before we made some changes, this is what the inputs were. And after we made the change, we can see what the inputs were. And it's just going to give us a breakdown sort of field by field what the changes were. And you will recall that I changed it from sunny to rain, and then changed the rainfall from 0 mils to 10 mils. So everything is timestamped as we go. And one last thing to show you is that if we send this form as a PDF or download it as a PDF, it's going to contain the version of the form on that PDF. So I've actually got an example here. This is of another diary. And the layout is very similar to what we see on the website. In the header, in the top right, we actually see the form version number, and in this case the form version is number 1, but if we were to export this one, it would say version number 3. So what's good about this is that it allows you to keep track, because when you download a form out of Dashpivot, you know, any changes that you make inside of Dashpivot won't be reflected anymore in the PDF. So it's really important to know on the PDF what version it was up to at the time that it was downloaded or sent to somebody. So that's what that's allowing us to do. And that's a summary of the sequencing for timeline style templates. We'll now head across and take a look at how this works for workflows. The sequencing is slightly different, which I'll show you. So when we first create a form, it actually starts as version 1, But if we save it and then make a modification, I'll show you it actually counts up by going to version 1.1 and then 1.2 and 1.3 and 1.4 and so on if we make some changes. I'll show you what that looks like. So you get the idea. It's ticking up 1.1, 1.2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. It'll just keep going. And the reason that we do it this way is because with workflows, it's a slightly different process. We have a series of columns, and the form needs to be approved to move through all of those columns. And assuming that everything follows that process to a T, it will just up-rev sort of in half steps like this, where we've got 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, and so on. But if we remove an approval signature and move it back to the start of the workflow process, to the beginning in the first column, we actually up-rev it a full step. So it'll go to 2.0 and 2.1, 2.2, 2.3 as it then moves through again. So as an example, let's now sign off this form. I know that we've left a lot of it blank, but I hope that you'll get the idea. I'm going to sign it and save. And you'll see now that it's moved across to the next column. It's this one here. If we open it up, you can see that it's continued to up-rev. After we sign it, it up-revs it as well. And you can see a history of all of the changes that have occurred so far. And that's fine. But because it's a workflow, this template, all of these fields are now locked. Everything that's above that first approval signature, which is down here, everything above this blue line here is locked. So if we wanted to make a change, we can do that. We just need to click this Make Changes button. But it will now, if we pay attention to the versioning up here, where it says version 1.4, if we click Make a Change, you'll see that it'll up-rev a full step. It's now version 2. And so we can now continue to make changes. You'll see that all these fields are now unlocked. You know, we can type in some information and make some changes and save it, and it's now version 2. And so if we, and you'll see that it's now moved back to the first column. And so you'll see that if we open it up again and then make some changes, it's now 2.1, and that will continue. So assuming that we don't remove any approval signatures again, it'll just continue as 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, and so on. But if we sign it off, again, we sign off one of those approval signatures and move it to the next column, and the next column and the column after that. If we ever removed any of those approval signatures, it would up-rev a full step again to version 3, and then 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, and so on and so forth. So that's how the versioning works inside of Dashpivot. We have some additional information in our workflows video and article in our Help Center. If you get stuck with anything, please do reach out to us via live chat, either on the Dashpivot website or within the mobile app. And as always, thanks for watching.